Hi students, welcome back. Let's continue with this data compression techniques. The another data compression technique is the jpeg encoding algorithm. So this jpeg encoding algorithm is a lossy data compression. So the what type of files we encode this jpeg encoding algorithm? So we will apply in digital image. So for digital image pictures, you have to, if you want to compress the files, you can use the .jpg extension. So if you want, what is, how it is going to compress the file, how it is going to compress the digital image? Now let's see. This jpeg stands for, J means joint, P means photographic, and E means experts, G means group. So jpeg is a joint photographic expert group. So it is a lossless compression algorithm for digital images. Actually, what it employs? It employs a transform coding. Using what technique? Using DCT technique. It employs a transform coding method by using the DCT technique. So what is this DCT? DCT is nothing but discrete cosine transform. So by using this discrete cosine transform, it employs a coding method. It transforms a coding method. So let me explain you how this jpeg schematic will be there. jpeg schematic. Okay. So first, I want to compress the jpeg file. I need to compress. Compression. So after, I need to decompress. So this is my aim. So first, what it is doing, it takes the color transform. So we are talking about the images. So images means obviously they are in color. It's a red, blue, green color. But jpeg will take another format of color. Okay, instead of red, blue, green, it will take it will convert it into YCBCR. Okay, so I'll explain later, but first it takes a color transform. So it is going to transform the RBG, red, blue, green color, to YCBCR. Okay, so color transform. After that, it is doing downsampling. So then apply the DCT technique, that is a forward DCT technique. Discrete cosine transformation. Then it quantizes. Quantization process will be there. Quantization. Then after that, it starts encoding. Then after encoding, compress the image data. So whatever the image that is there, it is going to be compressed. Image data. So up to here the compression will be over. After that, again I want to decode it. Use the decoding technique. So for decoding, you need to dequantization. So whatever the quantization is applied, that you need to be dequantization. So now you have to forward DCT, apply the inverse DCT. So this is for decompression. Then upsampling, you have to do the upsampling. And finally, your color transformation has to be again performed. Color transform. So this is all about jpeg decompression, and this is compression and this is decompression. So this is completely as jpeg schematic. Okay, so let me explain you the algorithm. So afterwards I'll explain an example of how the jpeg is encoding algorithm. Okay, So first what it is doing, I have to color transform I have today. Before that, first is splitting. So whatever the image that is there, that you need to be split. You have to split that image. So original image is there. That this is, let's take this is an original image A. I need to split this original image. Okay, so for that what I am doing, let me explain. Split the image into 8x8. This is an image. I am splitting this image into 8x8. Split image into 8x8 matrix, non-overlapping pixel blocks. Non-overlapping pixel blocks. So whatever the image that is there, that I splits into non-overlapping pixel blocks, that is the 8x8, means total 64 units are there. So here 64 units are there. Each unit you call it as a pixel. Just remember that. Each unit you call it as a pixel. So if the image cannot be divided into 8x8, you can add some more blocks here. And next, color space transform. Color space transform. So why I am doing this color space transform? Because if you want to convert the compress the file, the JPG will take here color space transform from RGB, red, green, blue color, to YCBCR. So here Y is nothing but the brightness, CB is nothing but the color blueness, color blueness. And CR is nothing but color redness. So instead of RGB, it is first it transforms the color into YCBCR. Okay. So actually RGB is a simple color space model, and that will be converted into this YCBCR. Okay. After that, what I had to do? The next step is apply the DCT. DCT, a discrete cosine transform. It takes take discrete cosine transform for of each 8x8 block. Apply DCT on each 8x8 block. So apply on each 8x8 block. Next, after that, according to the schematic, what I had to do next is a quantization. Apply quantization. Quantization. It quantizes the DCT coefficients according to the psychovisual time quantization table. So you have to quantize the DCT. Quantize DCT coefficients according to the. Okay. So according to the psychological psychovisually tuned quantization tables. So after quantizations, you need to serialization. Okay, here serialization, we are applying the zigzag scanning pattern. Zigzag scanning pattern. Why we are applying zigzag scanning pattern? To exploit redundancy. To exploit redundancy. So for that case, we are using the zigzag scanning pattern for the quantization. Okay, so next, vectoring. After that, you need to perform the zigzag scanning is over, you need to vectoring, means differential pulse code modulation, that is apply the DPCM, differential pulse code modulation on DC components. On DC components. So next, run. So after doing everything like this, means series is zigzag pattern, apply the run length algorithm. Okay, you can apply the run length or coding, encoding or Huffman coding, whatever it may be, you can apply that technique, the same procedure. So here you already know how to apply run length and encoding. So to make the data in this formatted, you need to do all these things, because this is an image, not the character. So first thing is, whatever the image that is there, that you need to be converted into text. After that, apply the coding, means convert into zeros and ones, and then compressed. So this is, so far we had seen this technique in the lossless. So here lossy, this is lossy. So here the image has to be changed. So you have to follow all six steps to convert the image into text. Okay. So this is about this JPEG schematic. So in the next video, I'll explain with an example so that you clearly understand what exactly the JPEG encoding was. Thank you.